And a very warm welcome to you, the Golden Years, Harry Golden and the Carolina Israelite. In 1958, when Harry Golden wrote Only in America, he was at the top of an incredible success story, his very own paper, the Carolina Israelite. It was monthly, had 16 very packed pages, and was as diverse and as interesting as its readers. Harry Golden wrote it from home, and every single word in this unique publication was his own. And Harry Golden's very own story was just as unique as his paper. When he was young in New York, he tried many things. He was a porter, salesman, editor, journalist, and many other things too. A great life for getting to know and understand people. And Harry Golden was also a brilliant writer and listener. He had all that was needed for success as a journalist, and after moving to Carolina, Harry Golden founded the Carolina Israelite, a newspaper with something for everyone. And the Carolina Israelite became a success. Many people said that Harry Golden's articles, which by the way he called editorials, were like letters from a friend. And when time came round for the paper, time came round for the family. Reading the Carolina Israelite together was the highlight of the month for many American families. But of course, sooner or later, everyone has to give in to age. And in 1968, Harry Golden wrote the last of his editorials and put the Carolina Israelite to bed for the very last time. And there has never been anything like it since. Harry Golden was a nonconformist, and that's how it was, and only in America. The Golden Years, Harry Golden and the Carolina Israelite.